Alejandro Ellis, 24, social entrepreneur.
Nikhil Arora, 24, social entrepreneur.
Back to the Roots is an urban mushroom farm in Oakland, California that grows gourmet mushrooms and mushroom kits on entirely recycled coffee grounds.
So Back to the Roots was founded during our last semester in college at UC Berkeley. We're sitting in a class, came across the idea, and I was going to consulting, he was going to invest in banking, and fell in love with that waste to food model, and next thing you know, you're graduating and full-time urban mushroom farmers.
Our vision with Back to the Roots is to create a movement and really a brand that stands for bringing people back to growing locally, eating fresh, organic food. Over these last few years, we've seen this huge growth in the industrialization of food, and we want to be the brand that stands for bringing back a connection to growing your own food with families across the country, kids, that they can grow their own food out of their kitchen, or they can grow food out of home, and they don't have to buy everything from the store.
Every morning we collect coffee grounds from all the local cafes in the area, about 20,000 pounds a week now of coffee grounds we bring back into our warehouse.
Coffee grounds come really moist, so we actually have this industrial press that removes all that moisture and makes it perfect for us to grow the mushrooms on.
Step three is bagging the dried coffee grounds into the kits, and that happens about once a week now at the back of our warehouse.
The fourth step is when we inoculate the coffee grounds with the mushroom seed, or mushroom spawn, which is what it's actually called.
The coffee grounds mixed with the mushroom spawn sit for about 3 weeks in our place, and their roots really take over the coffee grounds.
And then they're ready to be shipped after that.
All the leftover waste from our fresh mushroom growing process, which we were doing, turns into a great soil amendment. And then with the kits, any of your own waste at home, you can actually go back and add it to your plants as well. So it's kind of a zero waste product.
Back to the Roots was founded upon a mere idea, so we had no business plan. We didn't know that this would eventually turn into an actual business. We just thought it was really interesting and exciting that you could take an entire industry's byproduct and grow food on it. And over the few weeks that we started really cultivating this idea, we realized that this could be a really profitable entity, but at the same time provide jobs for the local community, and it would be a obviously very sustainable. By definition, our entire business is made out of another industry's waste. So we're not really striving to be sustainable. Our business is a sustainable entity.